Hey guys, what you doing? Welcome back to more South Park Encyclopedia. So how are you, South Parketeers? Good? You're good? I'm glad that you're good because I am fine also. Even though I am somewhat sick still. A bit. Just a tiny bit, but no problem. Let's start off with Hawaiian ID card. This is from the episode Going Native in the last. Is it the last season? No, I think it was in the season before that. So the second to last season, which has been put out at the time of this recording. Which I think is 16 actually. Basically it's this whole thing that basically it's about Hawaii, of course, and how basically people have started to either to buy property to make a vacation house, or just go there. And basically by just going there and staying there a bit, they feel themselves to be Hawaiian. And they said kawaii and shit like that, and the thing is that it's, as I said, it's kind of going native, as in dances with wolves. Only that, I don't know, it's from in my opinion, it was a pretty, I don't know, pretty not funny episode. Just Butters finding out that he is actually Hawaiian and that his parents are Hawaiian, even though they're not. They just went there for like a week or a month, and now they think themselves as a Hawaiian. That may have something to do with Obama, probably. But it's a huge fucking reach. I don't think that this episode has any input about Obama's birth certificate. Not sure. But yeah, and Kenny comes along. And so Kenny and Butters go through some adventures, some shit happens, and to be honest, I don't really remember because I watched this episode only once, and in my opinion, it wasn't very interesting. But yeah, that's where this Hawaiian ID card comes from. Next up, the head of the Powell statue. Feels like this has been looted before by someone else. Okay, this is a throwback to a season 6 episode, I think. Is it season 6? Yeah, it's season 6. The season 6 episode called Professor Chaos. Oh no, Simpsons did it actually. In that episode, basically the episode before that was the one in which Butters basically got thrown out of the group, because in season 6 Kenny was dead, like for good, and so they had to replace him with someone, and so they first replaced him with Butters, and Tremont has had this idea that okay, from now on, each run, because back then, the single season was a split up in two runs. The spring summer run and then the autumn winter run, and with a break between them. And so at the end of the run, basically the boys kind of decided to kick Butters out of their friendship group, and decided to hold auditions, like The Bachelor. And so Tweak got picked, and the fact that Butters got rejected brought out his evil side, which is Professor Chaos, bringer of destruction and doom. And so he started doing meaningless shit, like mixing up orders in restaurants, and stealing the blackboard eraser, and then at the end of that particular episode, There was this awesome thing they did where we're like, will Professor Chaos's plan succeed? Will the bo who will the boys elect to be their new friend? And who of these six characters will die and will never be seen again? The answers will be revealed right now. No, tweak, Michonne's on deck. And so yeah. Basically, it kind of gave you spoilers for the next run of shows. So yeah, then came the episode entitled "Simpsons Did It," where basically two things happen. One of the stories is basically Cartman dreaming of sea people. You know, those little things you get. Those little creatures. Basically, you put them in a glass, and then they build a society, and he convinces the boys to do it. I mean, to put some money to buy them. And they do, and you know they're basically little creatures. They don't do much, and Carl was imagining like, oh wow. The sea people will form a technology and they will shrink me down and I will be able to live with them away from this sucky world. And basically he got all disappointed. Then they decided to put the sea people inside Miss Choksondik water. However, once they decided that, it cuts to a scene of basically the coroner's taking Miss Choksondik's body away, and they said, "Dude, what the fuck?" And they actually thought that they had killed Miss Miss Choksondik. And then they see at they see the news and they see that they actually found semen in Miss Choksondik's stomach. And they said, "Oh shit, dude, they found our sea people. We kind of have to go tell someone and ask advice." And then they go to chef because that's what they always do. They go to chef. Chef asks them how are they? They say fine or no, and then basically they tell him their problem and he starts singing. Basically they say, "Chef, we killed our teacher and they found our semen in her stomach." And then Chef says like, "Oh children, that's something we all have to live we all have to live with sometimes. Here, let me sing a song. Sometimes a kilo teacher and they find a semen in her stomach and they, what the what?" And then he basically realized what he was saying, and he took the couch that they were on, and he like shoved it out of his house and closed the door. And then the boys kind of went to recover their sea people, and they found. Anyway, it was a gross fucking scene where basically Cartman hid inside the body because two coroners came in to check on her. Creepy shit. But yeah, then Chef comes. He tries to make them flee the country, you know, to safety, to be on the run. But then Chef tells him the difference between seamen and sea people, and he realizes that it was a giant misunderstanding. And then Carmen gets an idea. If I mix semen with sea people, then maybe something will work. And so Carmen goes to the semen bank, and basically he asks for a sample, and he like puts it on his hand and checks the viscosity and shit. And then he asks for all the semen they have. And then basically back home. He comes in with a fucking tub of semen, and he basically says that yeah, I got some from the bank, but But I also got some from this weird old guy in the back alley of the cinema, and basically it's just fucking disgusting because apparently he had to gather it in his mouth from a hose. So if you don't know the implication, then I'm not gonna say it because that's fucking disturbing. That's really fucking disturbing. But also very funny because now Perry Carmen is gay. Okay, so basically they do that, and in the end, the sea people actually build a civilization and start to worship Carmen as their god. And at the other end of the tank, the other sea people build a statue to worship Tweak as their god, because Tweak is now their new friend. And so the two parts kind of launch rockets at each other and kill themselves. But then Butters comes in and says, "Ha ha ha ha! Simpsons did it! Simpsons did it!" And that brings on the second story, which has been going on in parallel. You see, this whole episode kind of came from a thing that happens in the South Park writing room on a regular basis, because Trent Matter or someone else might come up with an awesome idea, and someone in the room would say, "Simpsons did it, Simpsons did it," and they would say, "What? Like, no fucking way. How is that even possible?" And basically it's their frustration that whenever they come up with a sweet idea, apparently the Simpsons had already done it. And so they decided to make this whole episode, Simpsons Did, where basically Professor Chaos tries to come up with plans to make chaos or something, create chaos. And basically Dougie, who is a general disarray, constantly tells him that Simpsons did. And one of those ploys involves Butters basically cutting the head from I mean of the of a statue in the middle of the town of South Park, the founder or something. And basically he said he was saying that no, there's no way that the Simpsons did this. And basically you see a newscast where basically the anchor says that someone has vandalized the statue of our founder. This that kind of reminds us of the time that Bart Simpson c cut off the head of a Springfield statue. Wow. It's great that someone is reminding us of how good a show The Simpsons is. So yeah, I'm basically, yeah. And basically Butters comes up with schemes, and Dougie says constantly that Simpsons did, yeah, we'll build a giant, I don't know, a giant thing that will block out the sun, and we will only give the town some power when we want it, or when they pay. Simpsons did. Okay, we will go and try to convince the mayor that they want to build a monorail. Simpsons did. That's basically the whole episode. Basically, Butters goes mad and snaps at the end. And basically, the lesson is that, dude, like, Simpsons has been so long on the air that, of course, they fucking did everything. So you're not supposed to be pissed off that you can't come up with this. The thing is that the Simpsons actually did this one thing w with the sea people, where they build a statue honoring Bart. However, as Trey and Matt said, they didn't do the sea people thing, which is something. Okay, highlighter. There's probably no better way to highlight things. Well, yeah. I don't remember. It's not a marker, it's a highlighter. I don't think highlighters have been featured, but a marker has. Actually, let's see. Do we have a marker? Please let us have a marker. Marker, yes, okay. So I won't talk about this because there's nothing to talk about. I shall be talking some when we reach marker, but until then, no. Unfortunately, no highlighter. Okay, ice cream. Taco flavored. Wait, what? Oh, shit. I thought this referred to another episode, but apparently no. Okay, I shall refer for this object to two episodes actually, and I think I will be going above the allotted time to do so. Okay, so there is an episode where ice cream is very prominent, I should say. It makes up an integral part of the episode, and then we have the words taco flavor, which points out another episode. Okay, the first episode is back in season 2, and it's called something like City on the Edge Forever or something. I don't know exactly what it was called, but it kind of pays homage to a classic Star Trek episode. A lot of the old and new South Park kind of pays homage to Star Trek because they have a few Star Trek fans there, and basically, yeah, they come up with the references all, well, not all of the time, but some of the time. Basically, the story is that the kids are riding in the bus, you know, on a mountain road, and you have Miss Crabtree there, which unfortunately is dead. So Miss Crabtree, now in the show, is dead for quite a number of seasons, unfortunately. And basically, you know, they Carmen is eating a cake, and the others tell him to give them some, and they say no, and he says no. I can't possibly eat one more bite. Oh, I try. Basically, you know, the kids from time to time say something naughty, and then Miss Crabtree turns around and says, "What did you say?" And then they say something which sounds the same, but it's not what they said. For example, when they say, yeah, screw you, fat bitch, she said, "What did you say?" And they say, "I said rabbits eat lettuce." And at one point, Carl says, "Damn it, Carmen, you fat fuck!" And she turns around, and then she loses control of the bus. And they spin around and basically land on a mountain edge, cliff edge, I mean. And so Miss Crabtree kind of goes away to look for help and leaves them there, literally dangling. So that sucks for them. And then Miss Crabtree basically gets a ride from a trucker guy who kind of, I don't know, I think he was supposed to look like Elvis or something. And then basically he gives her roofies, and she doesn't pass out, and then she asks for more roofies. So apparently Miss Crabtree, actually that's an interesting theory, you know. Probably Miss Crabtree is not influenced by roofies because she was given roofies a lot of times in her early years. And that made her immune, probably. So probably the reason why Miss Crabtree is like this, you know, this crabby, not pleasant person, is that she was basically date raped a bunch of times when she was a teenager or something. Just a theory, guys. Trailman, I haven't said anything, but I'm putting it out there. Miss Crabtree isn't affected by roofies, and so she must have immunity, which means she has taken them for a long time, which means she was raped a bunch of times when she was young. There you go. Okay, so basically, she meets him. They stop in a pub. A stand-up comedian was kind of performing. Miss Crabtree kind of embarrasses him and makes him pee his pants, and then a talent guy is there and offers her a job, and then she becomes huge with her stand-up, and she ends up with the Elvis trucker driver, and that's kind of it. And then we move on to the next story. The boys, basically, when they, as they are standing there plummeting, they kind of, this show is kind of a clip show, because they remember shit from the past, but events aren't like they were. So for example, they remember the episode from season one with Death, and basically where basically Death was chasing them on a tricycle, and instead of Death touching Kenny and killing him, Kenny kind of grabs Death's arm and then kind of, he like puts Death on the ground and starts jumping on him, and basically bones start flying, and then Stan says, "Oh my God, Kenny killed Death, you bastard." And then Kenny pulls out an ice cream and starts eating. And that's basically where the ice cream comes from. Basically, at the end of each thing, of each clip, as it were, they start eating ice cream. So for example, you kind of have the apart from the season one pilot. And basically, so it was that scene where basically, that one scene where Stan and Wendy were using Carmen as bait to lure out the aliens, and then Carmen farts, and instead of a giant, satellite dish coming out of his ass, an ice cream truck came out, and then the visitors were eating ice cream, and then Stan, French kissed Wendy, and that was the end of the clip. So that's the whole joke for the whole episode. Basically, they're remembering things that weren't thus. They're remembering wrong, and each clip ended with them eating ice cream. And at one point, a kid wearing a red shirt kind of went out, and a monster ate him. And then, a few minutes later, they remembered even that scene with the red kid, and basically the monster ate him, but then he pulled out ice cream and gave it to the kids. So yeah, but in the end, Kyle, of course, kind of insults Cartman, and then he goes to the other end of the bus, which of course puts it out of balance, and they tumble, and they fall onto ice cream, and then all of a sudden Cartman wakes up. Yep, it was all a dream. And basically, Carmen's mom comes in, and he tells her that he had a messed up dream. And then they start eating beetles. However, they of course eat beetles with ice cream. And then Stan wakes up, and it was all in his head. And basically he calls Kyle and says, "Dude, I just had the weirdest dream. We were remembering things that weren't right, and then Carmen and his mom ate beetles." Say, "Wow, that's pretty messed up." Yeah, I think I must be having some emotional problems." And then Kyle says, "Yeah, okay, hey, let's go to whatever, because someone did something. And Stan says, oh yeah, cool. And that's the end of the episode. Oh, and of course, Miss Crabtree apparently was in this episode a dream character. And the thing is that she realized she was a dream character. And she said, yeah, well, let's enjoy the moment while it lasts, which is very inspiring. The second one, the second episode. Wow, I am talking a lot today. The second episode is actually called Cancelled, and I think it's in season 7, if I'm not mistaken. And the whole thing started off basically with Matt and Trey realizing that near the season's beginning, they were about to reach their 100th episode, and they first said that, well, let's make this our 100th episode special. But then they went with a little bit country, a little bit rock and roll as their 100th, and they left this one as the season beginning. Basically, the idea was to kind of remake the first episode, but with differences. So basically, the first 1 or 2 minutes is almost exactly like the first episode of South Park. However, they kind of realize that it's a repeat, and Schiff kind of takes them to a friend of his who was a scientist, which basically the scientist friend is, for all intents and purposes, the what's his name? Goldblum, god damn it. What's his first name? You know, dude, the scientist guy from Jurassic Park, the scientist guy from Independence Day. It's Goldblum, but I don't remember his fucking first name. However, basically he is that scientist from Independence Day, where he makes these crazy free associations to come up with a plan to stop the aliens. For example, yeah, cold, virus, yeah. Wait a second, butt sex. Yeah, butt sex needs a lot of lupa, chupacabra, the Mexican goat killer of folklore. Folklore is tales from the past, which have sort of, I don't know, bicycles, binary. It's binary code. You know, it's crazy free associations, and they're making fun of that. But then, you know, you kind of have aliens discovering them. But before that, they try to make Karma's probe come out of his ass, and there's this funny scene where Karma refuses to let someone put a finger up his ass unless it's Kyle, and then basically when Kyle approaches, Karma farts, and then Kyle backs away. Then he tries again, he farts again, and basically it's this thing for like a minute. And basically, Chef said, "Damn it, boy, that stopped being funny a minute ago." But then Kyle tries again, and Karma lets one rip with greater force, and Chef says, "Hey, you know what? That was just funny again." But yeah, then they get discovered by aliens, and then it's this whole car chase thing, which kind of rips off the Dukes of Hazzard, you know, with that pause in the middle of the jump. Well, I guess these kids are in a lot of trouble, like a June bug in July or something. Who the fuck knows? Sorry. And then basically, the kids get kidnapped. They get taken to a spaceship where base where an alien disguised as Stan's dad comes out, and Stan goes, "Dad? No, I took the form of your father to be more pleasing to you." And then Stan's, "Oh, dude, that's lame. You know, that's what lame movies do." And then like, okay, then I'll reveal my true form. And then he basically transforms into this giant freaking monster-like creature who looks ready to kill. And then he says, "Ah, change back." And then he turns into, I don't know, he changes into Frank Sinatra, Santa, Saddam, you know, all these characters. And then basically after some attempts, the boys tell him to turn basically into an ice cream shitting taco. An ice cream shitting taco. So a taco who shits ice cream. And that's where this taco flavored ice cream comes from. Fucking great reference, what can I say? And so he starts to explain to them how basically Earth is just a intergalactic television show or a reality TV show, which started like millions of years ago when when they took people from different planets, you know, from planet of gold, planet of Asians, because apparently races and different animals can live in the same planet, you know. So they had so there has to be a planet of Indians, a planet of Asians, etc., right? But then Jeff Goldblum, fucking Jeff Goldblum, the Jeff Goldblum character kind of finds out that this secret that Earth is a TV show, and now the whole world knows it's on TV, and they act out, they know, and so then that kind of ruins the fun of it, and the network decides to cancel TV, and that means destroying Earth. And then you see this giant bulldozer in space coming and basically ramming Earth. I don't know what exactly it was hitting, but damn, that place must be level now. It was probably, who knows? Nah, you can see if you watch the episode. But then the boys kind of try to appeal to the head of the studio, I mean of the network. And so they go and meet the Jusians, because apparently Jews don't run all of the TV, but Jusians do. And basically, they're alien Jews, which look weird. So that's funny. The Jusians, by the way, are pure gold. And basically, they sup with the. With the kids, and apparently Kyle likes the shit that they're eating. Must be some relative, some distant relative. And Karen says, I wonder why." And then basically they go to a hakma bar, which apparently hakmas are the Jusian equivalent to titties. So basically it's an alien titty bar, where they get a stripper into a hotel room, and basically instead of, you know, doing things with a stripper, basically they start sucking on each other's jagon, which is this weird organ which they have n near their shoulder. Oh yeah, suck my jagon! I can't believe I just suck your jag on him, shit like that. Disgusting shit. And Kenny, of course, being Kenny, takes a picture. Which comes in handy after, because after the crazy night of sucking jag on and, you know, snorting alien cocaine, basically. They kind of blackmail them. They blackmail them with the picture, and they convince them not to destroy Earth and just, you know, wipe everybody's memories. And and they promised them that, you know, we have World War III to look up to. If you let us go, then we will do our best to be as violent and destructive as we can be. We still have so much potential for that. Which, of course, I hope that that won't be the case. I really hope that World War III won't start with the Russia and the USA being kind of dicks to each other. So of course they wipe everyone's memory and everything goes you know, in its regular flow. Holy crap, I talked a shit ton of time. Well, I hope you liked this part, this fucking long part in which I laid out a shit ton of information for you. That's it. See you next time. Bye.